Quick video on Coalition. For anybody who's new, we have a coalition going here. We got Yang Gang, we got Bernie-crats, we got Orb Gang, we got Tulsi-crats. So we need to stick together. I know it's primary season and, you know, we're kind of jabbing at each other. I'm saying if you're for Tulsi, Marianne, Bernie, or Yang, to not do that and be neutral. Just don't go after them. There's plenty of people to attack. Okay, you want to attack somebody? Attack Elizabeth Warren on her wishy-washiness. Attack Joe Biden on his pro-war votes. He has a buffet of options you can go after. He's just one of the worst candidates in the field. So there's no point for progressives to kneecap each other here. Go after the centrist, okay? They're the ones we need to beat. Go after Pete Buttigieg. Go after Cory Booker. Go after Elizabeth Warren, Joe Biden, and the establishment Democrats. So just stay neutral. Because I'm seeing a lot of sniping out there from Yang Gang on Sanders and, you know, Bernie-crats on Yang Gang. And, you know, it's really discouraging. And I know you might feel validated because there is a war of ideas going on between those two camps. But I'm saying you don't have to be a part of it. Be better than that. Be bigger than that. Like I said, there's plenty of other people who are not progressive-minded you can attack. And that's what primary season is all about. It's all about fighting, not fighting, but just sorting through each other's ideas, calling each other out, comparing. You know, and that's fine. It's kind of cutthroat. And like I said, that's all well and good. But let's leave the progressive candidates alone. And doing one better is being a coalition together. You know, Tulsi-crats, Orb Gang, Yang Gang, and Bernie-crats. You know, that's my coalition. I want that to be your coalition. I want that to be your team in the primary. I want you to spread your bets around the political roulette wheel. You know, have your number one. You know, there's nothing wrong with having your number one. Just have a number two, a number three, and a number four, and a number five in there. You want to throw a Warren in there. Like being all in for one candidate in this primary seems rather ridiculous, when you have so many options to choose from, and mathematically our number one may not get there, and it's likely it's going to happen, but that's why I said have a second, a third, a fourth, have a depth chart, first, second, third string. Think about it like it's a football game, you know. There are options this time. Back in 2016, it was Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton and some other chump. But anyways, you know, we started this primary with like 25 candidates. It's okay to have a primary coalition. In fact, it's healthy. It's healthy for all of us that we choose the top candidates in the field and support them. If you can't support them, just be neutral. Just don't say anything mean. Don't be an adversary to them. You know, if you're a Tulsi-crat, you know, leave Yang Gang alone if you have a problem with them. Bernie versus Yang, that's a big one going on right now that bothers me. Just let it go. That's all I'm saying. Just let it go. But anyways, let me know what you guys think. And I was thinking about leaving some links down below, but I'm out and about, so I can't. All right, so I'll just talk to you guys down in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, click the bell.